Hi, I'm Jared Hillam. Have you ever wondered how Google does their queries into their mountains of data, or how Facebook is able to quickly deal with such large quantities of information? Well, today we're going into the wild west of data management called big data. Now, while you may or may not have heard of big data and other terms like Hadoop or MapReduce, you can be sure that they will be a regular part of your conversations in the coming months and years. This is because 90% of the world's data was generated in just the last 2 years. Yeah, you heard that right. All the data in the world was mostly generated in the last 2 years, and this accelerated trend is going to continue. All this new data is coming from smartphones, social networks, trading platforms, machines, and other sources. Since a lot of this data is already available, the question is whether you're going to use it or not. In the past, when larger and larger quantities of data needed to be interrogated, businesses would simply write larger and larger checks to their database vendors of choice. However, in the early 2000s, companies like Google were running into a wall. Their vast quantities of data were simply too large to pump through a single database bottleneck, and they simply could not write a large enough check to process the data. To address this, the Google Labs team developed an algorithm that allowed for their large data calculations to be chopped up into smaller chunks and mapped to many computers. Then, when the calculations were done, be brought back together to produce the resulting data set. They called this algorithm MapReduce. This algorithm was later used to develop an open source project called Hadoop, which allows applications to run using the MapReduce algorithm. Now, with all these new terms, it's easy to get lost about what's going on here. Simply put, we are processing data in parallel rather than in serial. So why do we call it the Wild West of data management? Well, even though the MapReduce algorithm was released 8 years ago, it's still very reliant on Java coding to be successfully implemented. However, the market is rapidly evolving and tools are coming available to help businesses adopt this powerful architecture without the major learning curve of Java code. So should your business be getting into Hadoop? There are really two ingredients that are driving organizations into investigating Hadoop. One is a lot of data, generally larger than 10 terabytes. The other is high calculation complexity, like statistical simulations. Any combination of these two ingredients with the need to get results faster and cheaper will drive your return on investment. Over the long run, Hadoop will be part of our day-to-day information architecture. We will start to see Hadoop playing a central role in statistical analysis, ETL processing, and business intelligence. Intricity can help ensure your organization isn't missing out on any critical opportunities to leverage this architecture today. Intricity's early partnerships in the Hadoop space have molded our capacity to help our customers navigate this new frontier. I recommend you reach out to Intricity and talk with one of our specialists. We can help you evaluate the opportunities and architect a solution for your big data requirement.